to be in the church of the Lord. Amen. All right. How are we going to get this show started? So right now we're going to have a scripture and prayer by my cousin slash siblings, Paula, Stephanie, and Teresa. Y'all come on up here for the scripture and prayer. And after that, we're going to have the welcome by my cousin Jessica and my sister Regine.
Good morning. That was a little quick on me. I'll be reading from 1 Peter 5, 6 through 11. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Whom resist steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto this eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, established, strengthen, settle you. To him be glory and dominion forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning with thankful hearts, Lord. We thank you for allowing us to assemble together to glorify, honor, and uplift your name. Lord Jesus, because you are the only true and living God, we thank you. We couldn't thank you enough, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to have the dedication celebration on yesterday in honor of the highway naming of my grandfather, Lord Jesus. We thank you for continuously reminding us that all things are possible with you, Lord God. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. We couldn't thank you enough, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, I just pray. My prayer, Lord Jesus, is that that highway is drenched with your blood, Lord Jesus. That it is known for miracles, signs, and wonders, Lord Jesus. That it leads souls to Christ, God Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. As this service proceeds on the day, Lord Jesus, let us be mindful. When we come unto you, we cast our crowns, Lord Jesus. We are mindful that you are in control. You are in charge, Lord Jesus. There is no man above you, God. We thank you. We honor you. We love you, God. We love you, Lord Jesus. We love you, Lord Jesus. We love you, Lord. I can't thank you enough, God. I can't thank you enough, God. I can't thank you enough, God, Lord Jesus. As this service proceeds, open the minds, the hearts, the ears of the people, Holy Spirit. Sweep this place on today, dear God. Sweep it, Lord. Lord, that anybody that set foot on this pulpit on today, Lord, let the words that come out of their mouth be edifying to you, Lord, uplifting to you, Lord. We give all glory, honor, and praise to you. I seal this prayer in your Son's name, Jesus Christ. It is so. Amen and amen.
Good morning. My name is Regine, and this is my cousin Jessica. And we are so glad to see your beautiful smiling faces this morning. And we just love, we're glad to see you're here.
On behalf of the Cheek family and the Evangelistic Church of Deliverance, we want to welcome you to the grand finale of such a momentous occasion. We had a wonderful time yesterday. We celebrated the unveiling of the highway in honor of my grandfather, Bishop William H. Cheek Sr. today, as he would say, we are here to hear a word from God. We're excited to see so many members and new visitors here to celebrate the founder of this very ministry. God has granted us so many gifts and the opportunities to share and hear God's word. So we ask that you sit back, relax, clear your hearts and minds, and get ready to hear from a word from God.
Welcome.
Good morning, everyone. I'm still emceeing. Step right in. That's the program. But thank everyone from yesterday that came. It was a great service. And we just enjoyed ourselves. Calvin and I were talking, and we were saying people didn't want to leave. We just enjoyed ourselves out there. Brother Willie was DJing. And when it was time to go, he actually said, let the church say amen. We played that song. Guess what? Ain't nobody leave. I said, turn it up, Willie. Let's keep going, you know. So it was just a big family occasion. And this is what Bishop was about. And again, it's continuing today. We have another guest speaker. Or person we want to come up at this time. Yesterday he yielded his time to other officials so that they might come forth. But this is yet again another product of a legacy. His name is Tar Davis. And Tar will be running for office. He's already the county commissioner for Warren County. And I wanted Tar... This is Mellow Son, by the way. You see, he's cool like that, right? That's my cuz, right? and so we're just excited that he's in a position and in a place to be able to elevate the office to really help the community. And at the end of the day, Vernon can really say this. You can have officials that will come and do certain things, but do they really know the people? Do they really know the community? How can they really empower? And by having someone that you know personally, in those positions, you can attest to that. You can hold him accountable, or you call Mello, right? So at any point, though, I did want to give him time before Rachel continues on with the announcements. But I thought this would be a good break and a good time here to introduce Tar Davis, my cousin, my friend, and my frat.
So come on up and give us some.
Good morning. All right, now here we go. Most of you have known me my entire life, and it's okay with that. But I come from this church. Yesterday we celebrated an occasion that was due, rightfully due. But I remember across the street there. Y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. I am the grandson of Virginia Davis, a.k.a. Gingerbread. I am the son, none other than Mr. and Mellow Deborah Davis, right? Now, most of all, I'm going to take my seat. Tony, I see you looking at me, but it's okay. I'm going to take my time. I've got the platform. But your grandson of Evangelistic Church of Deliverance has come home. He's come home, me and my brother retired from the Highway Patrol for almost 30 years of service.
Yeah, thank you.
Now I want you to keep your clapping going because I got a story to tell you, then I'm going to take my seat. I remember Bishop Sunday School. Regular service. Sunday, evening service. I remember Wednesday night service. I remember Friday night service. Where are my junior bosses of deliverance at, huh? Oh yeah. See, I knew you were in here somewhere. Saturday morning, choir rehearsal. I remember. Lord Jesus, help me. I remember all the Christmas plays that we did. I remember Sunday morning, Sunday school. Where's my favorite Sunday school teacher, Miss Ruth? Is she here? Where's she at? She's in the background. Okay. There she's back in the back. There you are. But I remember those days. Pastor Cheek. He would drive those three things in us. Faith, family, education, the fabric of who we are today. But I come to tell you, your grandson comes back to this memorial occasion. And he comes back to report to you. There's a job that still needs to be done. You may say we've made it. Nice church. Fine cars, automobiles, nice suits. My dad put that in me. He's a little. But you know, we still can't top Mellon Davis, though. You know what I'm saying? But my point is this. Yes, as a sitting county commissioner, as a retiring state trooper. We still go out and we look at our communities. We still look at our economic equalities. We look at our education. We look at how we are progressing as a people. Can we say, have we made it? Pastor, I've went out and looked around in my days of being a state trooper. I see up is now down, and down is now up. I see left is right, and right is now left. I see forward is back, and back is now forward. Where have we come? Where shall we go? Have we continued to allow our communities to be struggling? That we do not stand up? Now I know where we are. We're in the house of God. But do I remember that they took a vote? Whether they was going to crucify Jesus or not. I'm no preacher, but I can have a story to tell that God has put in me. And have understanding that the fabric of who I am as a person, that I still carry the dream of all of us that we carry. To have a better life, to have the best education, to have the best health care. The best thing we can afford to ourselves, to pass on to our future. Evangelist, the church delivers your son to come home to give you a report card. The fight is still not done. Come go with me as we travel to the North Carolina State Senate. Thank you so much.
Difficult to come behind the state senator. Come on now. But I'm going to do my best. All right. Well, good morning. Welcome to the Evangelistic Church of Deliverance, and the Chief family is happy for you to join us in welcoming yet another day of celebrating. This has been a wonderful weekend of celebrating. And so we want to just take the time. Any visitors or new former members that are here, we just want you to wave, or if you want to stand. You don't have to say anything. No, they want y'all to stand. Okay, stand up. We just want to say hello and welcome, and thank you for sharing this occasion with us. You may be seated. Thank you so much. And Pastor Harris will be outside later. We'll greet you later after the service. And also, we are happy. I'm sorry. Oh, that must have been okay. Sorry about that. All right, so we're going to go on with the announcements for this week. So Monday through Friday at 6 a.m., we have early morning prayer in the chapel. Also on Tuesday the 16th, we have noonday prayer and fasting in the chapel. On Wednesday, April the 17th, we have Bible study and a prayer call at 7:30 a.m. Thursday, April 18th, we have Women's Empowerment on the Zoom at 7 a.m. Ladies, make sure you watch your phones now because the text messages are going to be coming out, so make sure you're on that call, okay? All right. And on Saturday, April the 20th, we have community outreach at 11:15 a.m. Please meet in the fellowship hall and contact Evangelist Glenn Johnson or Deacon Tony Cheek for further instructions. Also, on Saturday, we have financial awareness seminar at 1 p.m. Contact Trustee Calvin Lashley, and please sign up today so we can confirm with the parishioners? Okay, thank you. Also, this mark our calendars for May. We're going to have a Souls for Souls, and it'll be held in Garysburg on Saturday, May the 11th, from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. at the Old Garysburg Elementary School on Highway 46. The flyers will be available soon. So, we have some friends and family that we need to keep on our prayer list. We have Pastor and First Lady Harrison family. We also have the Cheek family for the passing of our cousin, Sister Emma Powell. Pastor Darrell Williams and his family. Minister Alice Johnson. Trustee Alfred Fleming and family. Mother Dorothy Hunt. Brother Albert and Junior Mother Gloria Turner, Sister Aileen Clark, she's home from surgery. We also have Lady Marlo Spain, pray for a good follow-up, a visit on Tuesday. We also have the Sharon family and the passing of Mr. Jeffrey Sharon. His service will be held tomorrow, April the 15th, at 1 a.m. at Smith Chapel Baptist Church in Halifax, North Carolina. Also, we have the family of Miss Lucy Moody Edwards, and the services will be held today at 2 p.m. at the Northampton County High School at West Auditorium in Gaston, North Carolina. So, in honor of the celebration this weekend, you know how Sister Ruth always give y'all a thought for the week. So, here's my thought for the week. Faith makes all things possible. Love makes all things easy. Hope makes all things work. And family makes life worth living. So now we'll have Miss Alyssa Lynch to introduce the praise dance.
Church. My name is Alyssa Lynch, and today we'll be ministered through dance by the New Spirit Dance Ministry from Word Tabernacle Church in Rocky Mount, North Carolina, where James David Gilliard is the senior pastor. New Spirit was formed in January 2021 under the leadership of Jasmine Clark and Mia Conception to cater to children in kindergarten through fifth grade with a desire to dance. These women wanted to create a space and opportunity where children who have a passion to dance could express themselves by sharing those gifts and talents back to God. At the time, there were eight young ladies who ministered the first dance during Word Tabernacle's 17th church anniversary to the song Jesus Said It. And that's what he's been doing ever since. God's hand of favor has been so prevalent within this ministry that it now has 28 dancers and three teachers. New Spirit has been nominated for the 2024 Music Choice Award in the category Best Praise Dance of the Year. This competition is currently open for voting, and you can go cast your vote at www.gospelmusicchoiceaward.com. Standing here today are the travel team dancers of New Spirit Dance Ministry. Please join me in welcoming them as they minister press in his presence. Thank you.
Anybody want to press a little further? Anybody want to press a little further? Somebody lift your voices to the Lord. Tell them, God, I want to press a little further.
Still believe, I
think about when you're praying and talking to Jesus, huh? That's when you give them your all, give them your everything. Amen.
All right, so as we prepare for the next best thing besides the word,
it's the offering.
Okay, all right.
So we know that God loves what?
A cheerful giver. Yes, that's right. So we're going to get ready to get the offering on the tongue.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Amen, amen. Amen. Another day that the Lord has allowed us to come together, and we can rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day the Lord has made. Amen. Amen. Thank God. It's offering time. It's offering time. Yes, it's offering time. Back in the day, we said this is happy time. Y'all remember that? We said happy time. Thank Deacon Parker for allowing me to come in his place today. Normally he does this. He allowed me to come up here. And I'm going to ask the family that's supposed to come to assist with the offering to come up to the front right now. Amen. And I made sure that they knew to make sure they have an offering, tithing, when they come up to work today. Amen. Thank God. Thank you, Jesus. And as they get prepared, I want to say thank God for our pastor, Pastor Harris, on today. Amen. Our first lady, Pastor Durrell. Thank you, sir, for coming. Bring your church family with you. That means a lot. Amen. Thank God for that. Yes. I feel so happy for this occasion. You have to realize that's my dad's name on that sign out there. That's my father's name on that sign out there. I'm so grateful for what the Lord has done. Amen. Woo! I thank God. Amen. When my sister and I got the idea that we was going to do this, she said, Tony, we got to do it. I said, yes, you're right. Commissioner Vernon Bryan came to my mind. I said, I got to call my friend to make this happen. And everything worked out just right. He knew all the contacts, the people that we need to talk to and make this happen. And everything was smooth. No hiccups. The approval process, I'm telling you all, the approval process went through smoothly. Everybody was on board with us getting this accomplished. All the officials, everybody, the mayors, everybody was in our corner. And now we here to celebrate. Amen. Amen. And I want to thank my church family again, Butch City yesterday. But I want to thank my church family for your love and your support. Amen. The ushers. Amen. Mother Lyons, the ushers, they're working. Trustee Fleming, security, working. Brother Willie Moore with the music. Everybody was coming together, working together on one accord. I thank God for that. Amen. So we're so grateful here on this morning. So we're going to have prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We give glory and honor to you, Jesus. This is the day you have made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it, God, that we're able to assemble together ourselves in this place, Lord. You heard the prayer request. We're praying for them right now. Every need, every situation, God. Heal sick bodies, deliver, God. Set free, Lord. They need your help on this morning, Lord. And I thank you for them, Jesus. They will come home with the victory in the name of Jesus. Bless us, God, as we raise this offering up, Lord. Touch the hearts of the people as we give. given unto you, God, with cheerful hearts and minds, Jesus. Given our tithes and offering unto you, Lord, let it be a blessing to this church as we move forward, God. This is kingdom work, Lord, and we honor you today, Jesus. Have your way in this service. Bless our speaker on today, Lord. Give him a powerful word from on high. We need it, Lord, the times we live in, Jesus. Anoint us afresh, and we'll thank you for it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank God. You can be directed by the ushers now. God bless you. Every Tuesday at 7:30, my family have prayer, scripture. We have our family conference call every Tuesday at 7:30. Y'all hear that? Hey, amen. Every Tuesday we have, and we've been doing it for, I think, about a year now, almost a year. And we average about 30 family members on our call, giving glory and honor to God. And he's blessing our family. And you know what? You can see the results of it. You can see the results of God has blessed our family. So I just want to make sure y'all know about that, and you can tell it. Please spread it around. Amen. Thank God.
Next, we will have the introduction of the guest speaker and guest saxophonist by my Uncle Edgar, and also a musical tribute as well by Deshaun Peel. God bless you again. As Bishop would say, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. We've had so many events, but now the most important part is where you get the feast on the word. We're so excited to have two individuals. He's also, I call him a friend of the family as well. Deshaun Peel, he's local. And as you notice, everything has been local, homegrown today. Through the whole event here, starting with Pastor Harris being the pastor of the church, right? Let's give it up for him, First Lady. Sister Shaman Harris, right? Homegrown, right? Let's give it up for her, right? You're going to hear a word from Burl Williams. Homegrown. Legacy. Right here. Deshaun Peel. Saxophonist. Right here, coming up next to you. This brother is so talented, so anointed to be able to play an instrument. And I was at my nephew's funeral, Ryan Lashley, and he played, and it was just so surreal that his skills and his talents just exceed. I've heard Kirk Whalen. I'm a jazz guy, by the way, too. You know, saxophonist, right? All of those guys who played. But Deshaun has something that goes beyond those guys. He has an inner ability to express through spirit and music to connect with his audience. And I'm just so excited and blessed today that he would come and bless us with his skills and his talents. Because you don't get this every day, but he's everywhere. You'll see him on YouTube and just everywhere. He's performed so many places because he's that good. After Deshaun plays this sermonic saxophone rendition, we're going to have a blessing that's going to come your way. As Tara said earlier, Darrell once sat in this ministry as a little boy, and I was going to let his assistant introduce him today, but I felt compelled to say a little bit more about him. He's the grandson of our mother. Mother, can you please stand? Mother Molly, please stand. Absolutely. That's his grandmother that we so dearly love. His mother served in the capacity of the worship leader for many, many years. Let's give it up for her, right? For his mother. That is in glory. And all these products that you're seeing here is part of Legacy. And so Darrell's going to bless us. And I had his bio. It's a little too long. It's so good because he's done so many amazing things. The only thing I hold against him just a little bit, he went to Central. I went to A&T. What kind of rivalries there? But nonetheless, we're all still good. But what I will say about Darrell is that he's done some amazing things. He is now the pastor of the Ascend Worship Church in Cary, North Carolina. Can you give it up? And I work with an individual that's part of his ministry. And I'll tell you how impactful he is. If you are a great leader, people will follow you. And Darrell has served in so many different capacities in different churches. And, of course, his wife, as I was saying, my mother, is locked hand in hand, step in step with him. So there is no division or confusion, right? They know their places and their parts. And that's what's been able to elevate him through various levels of the ministry. Daryl has served in upper room ministry at the youth pastor. He's traveled all over the world. Though he's local here, he's traveled abroad. Worked in major ministries, right? And that has given him a full complement and confidence to be able to build this now new church. But he's had a blueprint. His blueprint was started right here. And so when you think about legacy, it is amazing how people sit here. And Daryl was one of the quiet guys, right? He wasn't so like Butch, you know, right? So he was quiet, but his mom had to get him and grandma too. But look what God has done and is doing in his life. And so we're just excited to celebrate him, honored that he's here. And would come to bless us. And I think you see his church family, which is remarkable because he doesn't come by himself. He comes with someone and bring in someone. Let's give it up for his church, his wife, and he'll talk a little bit more about her. But without delay, after Deshaun Peel gives us a selection of his choosing, the next voice you will hear will be Pastor Daryl Williams from the Ascend Church out of Cary. God bless you.
Good morning. Before I play this song, I just wanted to give this quick story of my experience of Evangelistic Church of Deliverance. Back when I was in middle, I would say elementary, maybe middle school, I attended True Fellowship, which was right behind. So that small church back there used to be True Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church. And there, me and DeVito Austin, if y'all know DeVito, it's crazy to tell. But we used to go to that church. And he, at the time, he was a little bit more musically inclined than I was. And so one of the things that he was always like, hey, man, we gotta go over there to Church of Deliverance, man. And so I'm like, dude, like we in the middle of service. But it got to a time where every Sunday, when Reverend Moore would get up to preach, we would sneak out to church, come across the street, through the parking lot, come up the side. You probably can see our little heads bopping through those windows, come in the vestibule and just stand there and just listen. Because the music was bumping, the bass was hitting, the music sounded so good. And when I would hear it, I was like, man, we gotta go back to our church, man. We ain't got that over there. And one Sunday, we finally got caught. Both of our mothers, Sharon Peel and Javita Menifee, were standing with their arms folded, just waiting on us. And we got in trouble, but we couldn't get in but so much trouble because we was going to church. But I want to say that for me, Pastor and Bishop Cheek, what he did for this community in terms of, yes, the music brought me here, but there were some other things that kept me here. So besides that, you know, able to come in and play, me and Courtney was talking about it earlier before church started, but come in and play with Cornelius back then, and Haywood was just getting out and getting right. So that was for me, that was the end game at the time. I got to play a Church of Deliverance. And then it happened. And I was thrilled and still am thrilled to be considered a friend of the family and one of the sons of the ministry to a certain extent in terms of just musically. But I thank you all for you continuing to follow Bishop's leadership and continuing to follow what he instilled in just the church as a whole. And so, again, thank you for having me. But I want to tell this story real quick to let you all know that there is still greatness not only just in this area, not just in this church, but in this area. So again, continue to do what Bishop has already instilled in you all. Thank you again.
to Jesus, and Jesus is the center of your joy. Hallelujah. Wish I had about 25 people that would recognize and acknowledge that Jesus, through everything I've been through, Jesus is still the center of my joy. Oh, I wish I had about 5 people on this side, 10 right here, and 25 over here, that would lift your hands and give God some glory, that would lift your hands and give God some praise. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I remember my bishop as a praiser. And I wish I had some people in here that would give God some glory and give God some praise, because he's been the center of your joy when everything else failed, when nothing else came through, that God was still the one that came through for you. Come on, let's magnify him. Let's glorify him. Let's give him the praise that he's called for. Let's give God the praise that he's due. Come on, give him glory. Come on, that will give him glory. Come on, give him glory. God, everything that's good in my life, God, it came from you. Everything that's good in my life, God, it came from you. Has God done anything for you that's good? Hallelujah. Well, you ought to give him praise for it. You ought to give him worship for it. Hallelujah. You're the center. You're in the middle, God, of every situation, of every trial and test. Come on, bless his name. Bless his name. Bless his name. Come on, lift your hands right there. Lift your hands right there. Hallelujah. Lift your hands right there. Bless his name. Come on, give him the sacrifice of praise. Oh, from the fruit of your lips. Come on, bless his name. Come on, bless his name. Come on, bless his name. There he is. Come on, bless his name. Hallelujah. Bless his name. There's healing in his name. There's salvation in his name. There's deliverance in his name. I don't know what you need today, but I know it's found. It's in his name. Hallelujah. Come on, bless his name. Come on, bless his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run thereinto and are safe. Come on, there's safety for you in his name. There's safety for you in his name. There is no other name under heaven. Hey, the Holy Ghost is here. Whereby men may be saved. But at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So bless his name. I'm not going to wait till I get to heaven. I'm going to shout now. I'm not going to wait till the victory comes. I'm going to praise him now. I'm not going to wait till the healing comes. I'm going to bless him now. Anybody here got a right now praise for a right now God? Anybody here got a right now praise for a right now God? Anybody here got a right now praise for a right now God? Come on, bless his name. Come on, bless his name. Hallelujah, bless his name. He's worthy of it. He's worthy of this and more. He's worthy of this and more. He's worthy of this and more. David said, I'll bless the Lord at all times. And his praise shall continually. His praise shall continually. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Is there praise in your mouth? Is there praise in your mouth? Is there praise in your mouth? From too far not to praise him. He's brought me from too far not to give him glory. Is there a praise in your mouth? Is there a hallelujah anyhow? Hey, a hallelujah despite what I've gone through. A hallelujah despite what's hurt me. A hallelujah anyhow. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. And his mercy endures forever. And his truth endures all generations. I'm going to praise him because he's good. I'm going to love him because he first loved me. Anybody in here today know that God loves you despite what you did, despite where you were, that he still loved us anyway? Well, you ought to bless him like you love him. Hallelujah. Just lay hands on that person right beside you on their shoulder. Say, neighbor, I'm going to pray for you today. The Bible says, pray you one for another, that you may be healed. So Father, right now I pray, God, for my brother or my sister right now, God, you know what they're in need of. We're standing in the need of prayer. So God, I'm praying for healing. God, I'm praying for favor. God, I'm praying for turnaround. God, I'm praying for blessing. God, I'm praying for strength. God, I'm praying for power. God, I'm praying for love. God, in my neighbor right now. God, you know what they have need of. And I pray that your yoke-destroying power would show up in my sister's life, show up in my brother's life. In the name of Jesus, heal it, Lord. Come on, pray, saints. Heal it, Lord. Heal it, Lord. Strength, oh God. Hallelujah. Evangelist, the church of the praying church. Deliver it, God, in the name of Jesus. I bind the devil and we plead the blood of Jesus for my brother or sister right now. Bless their children, God. Bring them out where they need you the most. In the name of Jesus. Give a turnaround in their finances because you're able, because you can. Now lift up those hands and God, and say, it's me, oh Lord, in the need of prayer. It's me, oh Lord. It's me, oh Lord. It's me, oh Lord. It's me, oh Lord, in the need of prayer. Here I am again, God, and I need you every hour of every day. I need you in the morning. I need you in the noonday. If you need them, call on them. You're at the altar of grace right now. You're at the altar of mercy right now. And God, we need to hear. Oh God, from heaven today. Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way. Open the eyes of our hearts. Open our ears to hear what the Holy Ghost is saying to the church. In the name of Jesus, line me up with your will. Line me up with your ways. Line me up with your purpose. Line me up with obedience. In the name of Jesus. Father, line us up to please you. To be pleasing in your sight. To be pleasing in your sight. Ah, but to be pleasing in your sight. To be pleasing in your sight. Deliver every person that needs deliverance. Sanctify us afresh. Oh, God, we want to go back to being sanctified. Thank you, God, for making us dignified. But God, we want to go back to being sanctified. In the name of Jesus. God, we worship you right now. We give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. One more time, come on, bless his name. Clap your hands and bless his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, go greet somebody and just tell them God's going to do something special for you. Go greet somebody and just tell them God's going to do something special for you. Hallelujah. Just for you. Just for you. Just for you. Just for you. Hallelujah. We used to sing a song that said, just for me. When you start passing out blessings, Lord, have one just for me. We serve a God that has some just for you. Hallelujah. You have your seats in the presence of God. I love it. If you ain't figured out by now, I love the Lord. He heard my cry. Pitied every groan. As long as I live and trouble rise, I know where I'm going to run to. I'm going to hasten to his throne. Hallelujah. Anybody here? Every now and then you have to run to his throne. Every now and then you have to give him praise. Hallelujah. Come on, praise him. Don't let her praise him. Hallelujah. God, we thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, we give you the glory. Hallelujah. One more time, just say thank you real loud. Hallelujah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. We are so blessed. Amen. To be here in God's house. Amen. In the house of the Lord. One more time. I know some people, they still getting over COVID. I'm trying to figure out how many years. We three, four years. Sometimes I think we just need to get back to a place where we said I was glad when they said unto me. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go. I wasn't mad about it. I was glad about it when they said, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. So we bless the Lord, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. The King of Kings. Amen. The Lord of Lords, the only God, the only Savior,
Amen. There is no other name in the heaven whereby men may be saved. But at the name of Jesus, demons still tremble at his name. Amen. Sicknesses still are healed in his name. Amen. People still are getting saved all over the world. Amen. In his great name. Amen. We still give prayers answered in his name. Amen. So we just bless the Lord. Amen. For being able to be here today. And none other than the one and only. Ain't no church like it in the world. The elite evangelistic church of deliverance. Amen. Such a beautiful, beautiful occasion. Amen. It's the celebration of the highway dedication. Bishop William H. Cheek Sr. Highway, amen, is open for business. Amen. Amen. And then it's the clock. I might just ride up and down it just because I can. Amen. This highway got my pastor, my bishop name on it. Amen. You know, stuff you notice, you don't notice a car like yours till you get a car like yours, right? Then you see them everywhere. As I was riding here, when you see a thing, now you see it. And so you just see so many signs on the road as I'm riding here. Like, man, I ain't never noticed these signs before. I guess I noticed them now because my bishop got one with his name on it. So now I'm paying attention to him. Like, who is that? I don't know who that is, but I know who Bishop William H. Cheek is. Amen. I know. Amen. What God has done and has done and performed in our lives through the lives of this man of God. And we just thank God for this wonderful, beautiful occasion. Amen. To be able to be here. And I would come to serve if it was come to move tables. Amen. So just to be able to come and bless the Lord with my church families. Amen. It is nothing but a blessing from the Lord. So I thank you. I do honor our pastor today, Pastor Harris. Amen. God bless my friend. Amen. First Lady Harris, amen. Amen. God bless this man and woman of God who God has chosen and is using for such a time as this. Amen. We need saved pastors like them today. Amen. You would think that's automatic, right? You would think because you said saved and pastor, they go together. Amen. But it is not automatic that somebody that names the name of Christ, amen, that puts pastor or title or bishop or apostle or third ambassador to the fifth power. You know, we got all kind of titles these days. Amen. But those that would name the name of Christ and hold themselves forth as servants of the Lord and servants of God, people would have a relationship with God. So I just thank God for the character, amen, and integrity, amen, that this man of God and woman of God have walked in, amen, the support and friendship that they've been giving me, amen, down through the years. The Center Worship Church even exists because Pastor Harrison, when I was just praying about what God would do, and Pastor Harris said, man, the church is in you. Amen. We hadn't had the first service yet. Hadn't had the first Bible study. He said, but the church already exists because it exists to you by faith. So I thank God for that word. Amen. That word that, amen, that he spoke. Amen. Give him rise to just a few folks that's come with me from a Sin Worship Church. Just a few of you all can just stand and just wave so that people can just see you. Amen. Thank God for these wonderful, wonderful people of God. Just a few. Amen. Of people. Thank you. Amen. Come with us to celebrate this great occasion. Amen. I thank God for them. I had some people that came in. I think Chelsea drove in from 3 hours away. Amen. And she had from Aberdeen, North Carolina. And Marlene and Corey, they drove in from Greensboro, North Carolina. So people driving from near and far. Amen. And Raleigh and Harry and Nightdale to be here. Amen. With us in this great occasion. Amen. I do thank God for all the men and women of God that are here, all the ministers and elders in their respective places. Thank God for our deacons. Amen. Today. Amen. Amen. Deacon Tony Cheek. Amen. God bless you. Amen. My good friend and brother. Amen. Thank God for him. These leaders that hold up the pastor's arms. Amen. Serve and support of the ministry. Thank God for the Cheek family. Amen. God bless. Amen. The Cheek family. Yesterday, I was telling them before we came out, you know, when Edgar said yesterday, he said, I want all the Cheek family, all the cousins to stand up. I like to stood up. I was trying to, in my mind, say, my mama got to be kin to them some kind of way down the road. I was searching for the family tree. I started to get on Google right there and see if I could go to Ancestry or something and find a link so I could be a cousin. But, amen, Jonathan will tell you, Minister Green will tell you, I adopt myself in the family, so. Just know y'all have another cousin as of this day. Thank you. I ain't even two hand claps to say I'm official.
Amen. So thank you. God bless you. Thank you, Chief Family. Thank you, Edgar. Amen for the invitation to come and serve today. I would not go one step further. Without acknowledging this great woman of God who's just been a blessing my entire life since I was born, since I drew breath. My very own grandmother, Mother Irma Motley. Amen. God bless her. Amen. She was there when I was born. Amen. And been praying for me and encouraging me and keeping my grandma, Cousin Fanny, my grandma text you a word. I'm going to tell you now. My grandma, she texts you a word. Just know that thing is coming to pass. Amen. I talk to people about her all the time. Amen. I see my grandma in her 90s, and she on Facebook. She sends text messages. Amen. She on the Facebook. So I thank God for the woman of God that she is and the love, amen, of our family and lives. Just to be able to continue to have her and see her, it always lights up my month, my year. Amen, and my day. I know I got a few fellow relatives in here. I do thank God and acknowledge that before them all, I am still the favorite. Amen. God bless you. I appreciate my brother Daniil being here. Amen. Good to see him. Amen. Daniil just won the state championship. Was it the state championship? Conference championship for his first year coaching basketball. Amen. Won the conference championship, first year coaching the team that he was coaching as their head coach. And that led them all the way to the conference championship. Amen. And thank God for my brother, my son, Jonathan. Amen. Today he's in high school doing so well. And I appreciate him and all that God. He helps me out so much. He's our chief adjutant. He makes sure pastor's good. And he makes sure my stuff is where it needs to be. He's thinking ahead for me, trying to make sure I have things and when I need them. So I appreciate him. And he don't just do it because I make him. For the most part. He does it because he wants to serve his pastor, his father. So I thank God for him. Amen. You see him coming on down the road to my beautiful wife, Donna. Amen. Thank God for her. Amen. My best friend. I was thinking about her the other day, and how I remember when we were in our 20s. We're a little bit further along in the 20s now, but how God has just knit our hearts together from such that we've spent probably over 20-something years of our lives together as friends, as brothers and sisters in Christ, and chased her around. Until I finally got her to date, and then I had to chase her around and chase her around, and until I can say, till I can propose her, and she said yes. So I was so blessed when she came into church that day, First Lady Harris. I came to church that day to get saved. When I came in church, I said, Lord, now I need a wife if I'm going to stay saved. And God knows how to provide, just like you call Edad. I looked behind me, Ekachik, and there she was, and she was glowing. It was like music was playing. And when she came into church, I ain't going to say it because it's a sanctified church, but it was like music that was playing. Amen. When she came in the house of God that day, and God has just blessed us to be together, have wonderful children, and a wonderful life together. So I appreciate her. So turn with me to 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy chapter 3. Amen. Verses 10 through 14. I do thank God for our youth pastor. Amen. For Assemblies Church Minister Jonathan Green. Amen. That is here. Amen. With us. And so many of the workers and leaders that are here. I pray, our minister, our praise and worship leader, Tish, is here. Our married couples president, Reggie and Charlene Williams, directors, they're here. And our drummer is here. And amen. Our women's ministry, Donna's the wife of the women's ministry. Our men's department president is here. Amen. So we brought everybody that could. I was texting. Come on. Oh, you need me to come? Here's the YouTube. Watch it live. So. Amen. So to those that are watching from Evangelistic Church family and to those that are watching from a sin, God bless you. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 10 through 14. But you have carefully followed my life, followed my doctrine and manner of life, purpose, faith, long-suffering, love, perseverance, persecutions and afflictions, which have the afflictions which happened to me at Antioch and at Iconium and Lystra, and the persecution I endured there. And out of them all, the Lord delivered me. Not some of them, but out of them all. Everything I went through, God delivered me. Sometimes I just like to, when I'm encouraging people, and sometimes we feel like, man, the world is coming to an end, and we're in this crisis situation, and you look back, and when that thing that was a crisis today, you look back 6 months ago, and some type of way God worked it out. Sometimes we don't come back to give him praise that the world didn't end, that everything didn't fall apart. So sometimes we got to come back and look back and say, man, that thing I forgot about it. That thing I was so worried about and crying about and stressing about, I forgot all about it. But God was praying and believing God, and God worked it out for me. The Lord delivered me out of them all. Yes, he says, all who live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. Everybody won't like you because you're saved. Not everybody will like you and call your name and invite you to the party and invite you out to lunch and throw you a parade and celebration because you are saved. All that live godly in Christ Jesus. If we live this thing right, eventually somebody might not like you as the light continues to shine in the dark places. He says, but evil men, the seducers, imposters, he says, will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But you, verse 14, is what we want to be, must continue in the things that you have learned and been assured of, knowing from whom you have learned them. I want to talk today about continuing. The message is, continue. I love what Edgar said yesterday, talking about legacy, and as I pondered even on the topic of legacy and how what Bishop left for us is more than just history, but he left a legacy. The word legacy gives you even a feel that you should be focused on the past. But really, legacy in actuality is really about the future. All we do in life, everything we accomplish eventually becomes history unless somebody picks it up and carries it forward. So at the moment someone picks up our history and carries our history forward to continue it, history becomes legacy. What we did this weekend and what God blessed the Chief Family and Evangelist Church of Livers to do this weekend was not just a monument to the past. It's not a statue to be admired only, but it's a beacon toward the future that everyone that drives down that highway can be reminded to continue. Highways are not designed to look back. You don't see, or you shouldn't see at least, if you see them, you can call my friend Tara or Tommy to come get them. But you shouldn't see someone driving backwards down the highway. You shouldn't see someone driving down the highway looking backwards. Highways, by their very nature, are designed for you to go forward. The highway, the obstructions that keep you from being able to move forward have been removed. The way has been cleared. Somebody has cleared the way so that all you have to do to go down that highway is to continue. God, we thank God that his goodness, that he used Bishop William Cheek to clear the way through the word of God, through faith and through love, through holiness. And through obedience to God. Some of us remember that when it wasn't a popular thing to call yourself a holiness person. Some of us remember the time that they used to talk about you when you were holiness and say, oh, you go to the sanctified church. You're one of those holy rollers. Yeah. Oh, now we sing in church, oh, holy, you are holy. But then it wasn't a popular thing. To be holy. He paved the way and cleared the way through his lifestyle, through his character, through preaching the word of God, so that we could have an idea of what holiness and faithfulness and obedience to God look like.
He paved the way, cleared the way, removed the obstructions, so that we can know what it was like to live a life full of the Holy Spirit.
I remember when we used to work the cameras and videos in the balcony of the chapel.
And I think two was over the video then back then. I forget who we all had working on the videos, and we all kind of took turns, and we all kind of worked for Sister Ruth, and we were making videos and making tapes. And I remember somebody telling me then, we were at the balcony of the church on Revival, and you still saw the Holy Spirit come on somebody. And I remember somebody telling me, video that. And I was afraid. Like, no, man, that's God is touching that person. And I don't know if I should be capturing somebody in the video that the Holy Ghost, whoever this ghost is touching. But Bishop, he taught us the Holy Spirit. He taught us who the God third person Trinity was, and so he paved the way for us to be able to just continue.
Set an example for us to be able to follow, so that all we have to do is go forward.
Yeah. Paul cleared the way in our text for Timothy. So that all Timothy had to do was follow Paul's example.
Follow his example. Paul said, you follow my teaching, my conduct, my purpose, my faith, my patience, my love.
You follow. You knew what I went through. You were there when I went through troubled times. You were there when I was persecuted. You were there when I was suffering and kept and stayed faithful to God despite the challenges that I was having. Timothy, you followed my example. And even though Paul knew at the time that he wrote this letter that he was about to go home to be with the Lord, Paul was locked up at this time in a prison called Mamertine. It was the prison that nobody wanted to go to. Like somebody said, you're going to Caledonia. It's a prison that nobody want to go to. It ain't a prison that you go to like a button or a federal prison where they got TVs and all that. No, if you went to Mamertine, sometimes people died in Mamertine. Paul had been locked up before, but last time he was locked up, he was on house arrest. He had a little ankle thing around his ankle, but he had it pretty good. People can come visit him. People can come see him. But this time when he's locked up in Second Timothy, he's locked up in Mamertine, and the only way somebody could come see you was to bring you a little food, and even then their lives would be in danger.
Yeah. He's swept up in the persecution of Nero and says to Timothy, the time of my departure is at hand. I'm about to leave you, Timothy, but I need you to continue. I'm about to leave you here, but I have finished my course. But I've run my leg of the race. But Timothy, the race is not finished.
We got to know in here, Evangelist Church of Deliverance and a Sin Worship Church, that Bishop only passed us the baton.
He's ran his leg of the race, but just know that the race is not finished. That we, you and I, have a leg to run in this race to carry the baton forward, to follow the example of God of enduring, to go through even when life and times get hard. The saints used to sing, I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. And then they would say, I came out here to stay, Lord, not until I get tired, not until I get sleepy, not until our time is up and it's time for me to go home, not until Mayflower Cracker Barrel open. But they would say, I come out here to stay, Lord, until I die.
Difficult times may be ahead. Thank you, Holy Ghost, for the local church.
Difficult times. As we see even last night, the bombing by Iran of Israel. Difficult times may be ahead for the people of God locally and globally. I know we want to believe everything that come on TV and people saying, well, there's going to be an end time revival and everybody going to get saved, but that's not what the Bible says. But the Bible says there's going to be a falling away first. It says that evil men, people on YouTube and TikTok, people on Instagram, and people on Facebook that teach the wrong thing, that say that evil men and seducers will wax worse and worse. Time is not going to come where they all try to get right. The time is going to come when they get worse. The time is going to come when they teach even crazier things. The time is going to come when they say things that are not even more aligned with the Word of God. And even personal times that you may be going through right now, challenges and hardships that you would have never thought or imagined that you personally would have gone through or be going through right now. But I came to encourage you today that you have everything you need to finish the course. You have everything you need to run your race. You have everything you need to finish your leg. You have everything you need to follow all that God said do. Our bishop used to say, Grandin, the Word of God says that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. I feel my help now. Because Jesus hasn't changed. The Bible hasn't changed. The Word of God has not changed. The Bible says that Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. God has not changed. The word of God has not changed. The person that has changed in me. Maybe I move further away from God. Maybe I don't hold on to God like I used to. But I can tell you, He's the same God. He's the same Savior. He's the same Redeemer. He's the same God that was with Paul, when Paul said, out of them all, God delivered me. He's the same God that was with David when David said, this poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and delivered him out of all of his troubles. And I don't know about you, but I've been in some situations where I had to cry. I've been in some situations when nobody was there. I've been in some situations where there was nobody to call on. When I didn't have nobody to text. I didn't have a pen pal to call. But I can tell you that this poor man cried, and the Lord heard him. And delivered him out of all of his troubles. He's the same God. The same God that was there with your mother. He was good enough for your mother. He was good enough for your grandmother. He was good enough for your father. If he was good enough for them, he's good enough for you. The same God that was with Bishop. The same God that has heard your prayers in the past. Has God done anything for you in the past? Has God brought you out before? Has God done it in your life before? Well, I can tell you, God has not changed. He's the same yesterday. Today and forever. And I came to encourage you today to hold on to God because he won't fail. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He won't fail. It's the blood that still gives me strength from day to day, and it will never lose its power. The devil is trying to convince somebody out here today that God has changed. But I've come to tell you that he's still a way maker, that he's still a miracle worker, that he's still a promise keeper, that he's still a deliverer. You ought to praise him today because he's the same God. Come on, give him praise. Give him praise. He's the same God. Hallelujah. God, we serve, his grace and favor continues and is still with his church. His grace and favor continues and is still with those that believe and call on his name. Now, we can't get stuck in 100 years ago and continually point to what God did 2,000 years, 100 years ago, 50 years ago. I'm always looking back. As though, man, back in the day, God used to move. Oh, back in the day, we used to have some church back in the day. Oh, back in the day, when God used to show up back in the day. We act like God has gotten tired. We act like God has gotten old. We act like God has run out of steam. We act like God has run out of energy. We act like God has run out of grace. We get old and tired. We need naps. We go to bed by 8 or 10, 9 o'clock. We need to take a break. We get weary. But have you not heard that the Lord doesn't get tired or faint? Today that have no might, he increases strength. The Bible says even the young people, even the youth shall faint. But they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. The Bible says they're going to mount up with wings like eagles. They're going to run and not be weary. They're going to walk and not faint. You know, when an eagle mounts up, it's not riding on its own strength. Hold on a minute, Brother Willie. An eagle is not riding on its own strength. An eagle is soaring on the strength of the wind. And Eve, I don't have to flap. I don't have to wear myself out if I would just pray. I don't have to wear myself out if I would just fast. I don't have to wear myself out if I would just believe God. Because now I can ride on grace. I can ride on mercy. I can ride on favor. Wait, I say, on the Lord, and he shall strengthen your heart. Come on, tell somebody, wait on him. Wait on him. Tell somebody on the other side, lean on him. Lean on him. He can carry if you lean on him. He can help you if you lean on him. He can strengthen you if you trust in him. Come on, lean on him. Come on, tell one more person. Wait on him. Lean on him. Trust in him. Hallelujah. He carries his anointing forward. He carries his anointing forward to the next generation who will believe and continue. His anointing is not stuck and locked up in a bank account that we cannot access, that somebody threw the key away to 50 years ago, but his anointing and his grace and his power and his love is available to us right now in this place. And that God, the Bible teaches, said, I will never leave you nor forsake you.
He said in the word. He said to Joshua, as I was with Moses, so shall I be with you. The same faith you saw Moses like, it continues with you.
He said to Abraham, I'm giving you this promise.
Why? Because it's going to continue.
He says, because Abraham is going to command his children after me.
I trust that Abraham is going to make this thing continue. And so now Abraham tells Isaac, and then Isaac tells Jacob, and then Jacob tells the 12 tribes. And so it continues from one generation to the next.
David said, Lord, even when I'm old and gray, you won't believe it, but look, Darren, I'm about 40, I turned 50 this year. But even when I'm old and gray, David said, Lord, don't forsake me. I got little gray hairs now. My hair ran away from my face some years ago. That's all I got is the gray hairs on the little chinny chin. But David said, Lord, even when I'm old and gray, don't forsake me until I can give your strength to this generation and declare your power to all those that are to come.
The word of God came to David about continuing. David, this thing that's in you. You're a man after my own heart. And I'm going to make a covenant with you, the Lord says. And it says the covenant is going to be that you shall always have a man to sit on the throne. That your descendant will sit on the throne forever.
That you always have one of your boys, one of your offspring that's going to sit on the throne.
And then next thing you know, hundreds and thousands of years later, Isaiah prophesied what would happen in a few years. He said, Isaiah said, then unto us a child is born.
I know it ain't Christmas, but unto us a son is given.
And they shall call his name Emmanuel. For he shall be God with us. And then the Bible says the government shall be on his shoulders, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. So then, one day, as this continuing, there was a woman named Mary who had been minding her own business, trying to live holy for God. And an angel came to her and said, something is about to continue in you.
Oh, Mary, full of grace, that good will towards earth and peace toward all men.
That God's going to do something in you, Mary. That's going to continue what he spoke through his servant David.
And then Jesus was born of this woman.
Even our Lord Jesus Christ wanted the gospel to continue.
after his ascension, after he ascended to the right hand of the throne of God, before he got up on that good day, getting up morning, now before Jesus went to the right hand of the Father, he chose 12 men, the word of God says, to be with him. And then one of them, Peter, who was always running out off at the mouth saying stuff he shouldn't say, always the main one talking, always talking out of turn, saying inappropriate things. This one time, Peter got it right. When Jesus asked and said, who do men say that I am? Peter said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus said, upon this rock, upon this revelation that I am the Christ, the Son of the living God, I'm going to build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And ever since that day, 2,000 years ago, one person has told another, has told another, building and growing his church, because the word of God, Lord God wanted his word and his gospel to continue. And so it just went one person testifying to another, saying, Jesus is Lord. Then that person going home and telling their family, Jesus is Lord. I remember when my Aunt Mary was telling our family about Jesus, and my grandma came to Christ. My mother came to Christ. And then one day, my mother said, when I was in the kitchen, she said, one day, you're going to come in here, and all you're going to see is mama clothes. She was telling me about the rapture. She was telling me that Jesus is Lord. And one day, Jesus is coming. That didn't make me get right then. It didn't make me get it together right then. Matter of fact, Minister Parker, I would go in the bedroom at night after we came back from doing all kind of foolishness and checking in. She was still in there, okay? Jesus didn't come back tonight, so I may got one more day. But was she testified to me that Jesus is the Son of God. Amen. I came to church and I'm sitting in the balcony. I would have to shut out with Bishop because I was getting convicted because of Fanny when Bishop was preaching. And I felt like if I kept listening to him, I was going to end up running out and get saved. So I used to sit in the balcony and play movies in my mind. I was all kind of superheroes up there because I was trying to keep from being saved. But one day, something got a hold of me and made me lift up my hands and tell somebody that Jesus is Lord. And now I'm telling others that Jesus is Lord. And thousands of miles later, thousands of years later, the gospel is still continuing. And anybody here can testify that somebody told you that Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus said, upon this rock, y'all ain't going to like me in a minute. Jesus said, upon this rock, I'll build my church. He said, I ain't worried. Gates of hell won't be able to prevail against it. Nero that put Paul in prison and the Caesars couldn't stop it. The atheists and the agnostics couldn't stop it. The Muslims and the Buddhists and the Hindus couldn't stop it. The LGBT community couldn't stop it. Are you a he? You were born a he, I'm going to call you he. You a she? You born a she, I'm going to call you she. You are not more than one person, I'm not calling you they. Amen. English has meaning and words have meaning. You are not plural. You are one person. Amen. And so the LGBT community, RXYZ, how many letters they want to add, they won't be able to stop it. Because Jesus said the gates of hell shall not prevail. Won't be able to stop what God's going to do. Won't be able to stop the word of God. Won't be able to stop the gospel. I won't be able to stop his church. Because the Lord said, lo, I am with you always. I'll never leave you, nor forsake you. And Jesus said, I know I don't have to worry. I'm about the devil stopping me because Jesus didn't leave me by myself. He didn't leave me by myself. I thank God for my church family. I thank God for my wife. I thank God for my brother. I thank God for a city worship church. But I can tell you that on top of all those things that the Lord had left us by ourselves, that the Bible says, Jesus said, I'll send you a helper who will be there with you. And Bishop will tell us that this helper is going to give you power. Power to go through. power to not to quit, power to live holy, power to love your enemy, power to cast out devils, power to win souls, power to overcome addictions. I'm that the helper is a helper that gives you power. I'm that it may look like I'm by myself, it may look like I'm alone, it may look like I don't have a friend in the world, but don't worry, I've got help. It may look like I'm struggling, it may look like nobody's gonna come through for me, but don't worry, help is on the way. You may be asking, why are you still here? Why are you still holding on? Why, after all the things I've seen you go through, are you still believing in Jesus? It's because I'm not looking to you. I'm not looking to the Facebook. I'm not looking to TikTok. I'm not looking to who's in the White House. I'm not looking to who's down the street. I'm not looking to who's the government leaders. But the Bible says I look to the hills for where my help comes from. All my help, it comes from him. Anybody here can testify that God has been your help when trouble rises. That God has been your help when nobody else can be there. That God has been your help. Somebody ought to praise your help today. Hallelujah. Come on, praise your help. I feel him right there. I don't know what you need help with, but I came to prophesy to you today to say help is on the way. Help is on the way with your child. Help is on the way with your marriage. Help is on the way with your health. Help is on the way. Somebody give him glory. Hallelujah. So there's no need for me to quit. There's no need for me to quit. There's no need for me to give up. There's no need for me to throw in the towel. There's no need for me to say no mas. The boxing fans will know about that. There's no need for me to throw in the towel because I'm not alone. I've come this far by faith, leaning on the Lord, trusting in his holy word, and he never failed me yet. Somebody say, oh, I can't turn around because we've come this far by faith. Somebody praise him if you know you come this far by faith. And you got it in your mind that you're not going to turn around. You're not going to quit. You're not going to give up. You're not going to throw in the towel. But you made up in your mind that for God I live and for God I'll die. You made up in your mind that you're going to continue. You made up in your mind that you're going to stay with Jesus and you're going all the way. Somebody praise him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I came to encourage you. I just stopped by here. I stopped by here on a Sunday morning with just a few folk from a sin worship church to encourage you to continue. Somebody is saying that it hasn't been the same since I went through what I went through. It hasn't been the same since I experienced what I experienced. I've had a lot of hard things that have happened in my life, and I've tried and tried and tried, and I can't keep seeing to make the progress that I think I ought to make. I came specifically to talk to you today to encourage you with the word of God to say, God said, He's not done with you yet. He's not done with you yet. Your story is not finished. That God still has great things in store for you that eyes have not seen nor ear heard. People ain't even thought about the things that God wants to do in your life, but God's going to reveal it to you by His Spirit. Come on, touch somebody and say, He's not done with me yet. Paul said, everybody standing. Paul knew the times that were ahead. Paul knew. Go ahead and praise him. Go ahead and praise your help. There's a praise in the house. Praise your help. Hallelujah. Help is on the way. Praise your help. You know he's not done with you yet. You ought to praise him. For somebody, Satan said it was over. For somebody, Satan says you were finished. For somebody, Satan says, go ahead and get the divorce. Go ahead and file for bankruptcy. For somebody, Satan said it's over. They're going to repossess everything you got. But I came to tell you, he's not done with you yet. Hallelujah. Paul knew the times that were ahead were going to be rough for Timothy. But he says, Timothy, when I'm gone, Timothy, when I'm gone, continue. Timothy, when I'm gone, I'm about to be finished with this, Timothy. I run my leg. But when I leave, continue. Keep going. keep pressing forward. Keep moving on. Rough times are ahead. Timothy, I've already cleared the way. You just got to walk in it. I've already showed you the example. You've already got to walk. You just got to walk in it. Only thing I need you to do, Timothy, is just to continue. What I know about our bishop. What I know about Pastor Harris. What I know about these men and women of God that are here. They believe God for us to continue. I remember being in Bishop's office. And I think I was supposed to speak that night.
He was about 80 then.
And we were headed out. And I watched him skip down the stairs. And you know, I think I was in my 30s. And I was taking time. And Bishop kind of skipped down the stairs. And when we were talking about the things that God, he was believing God for. And I'm sitting there looking at him as a young guy. Because I knew, you know, I'm coming up with other pastors and seeing, man, you know, building churches seemed like it's a young man's game. You know, you got to have a little bit of energy for that. And there was to know that he had a vision to continue. And then when it's all said and done, and I know, and you and those of us in here that know Bishop, that he wouldn't want us to continually be stuck.
Well, what Bishop wants us to do is to continue.
Keep living for God. Keep living holy. Keep worshiping him. Keep being saved. Keep winning souls. Keep going forward. He would want us to continue. That's what Paul wanted for Timothy. Timothy, I finished my course. Now it's time for you to finish yours.
Bishop is done with his course.
Highway is reminding us that we've got to continue. So I want to pray for some people today. Amen. While my brother Willie is playing. I want to pray for some people today. I want strength to continue. I can tell you that's something I need. Every now and then, I want strength to continue even when I feel up. Sometimes you feel up and feel like things are going good and you wanted to keep going. I don't want this to die out. God, I continue as God. Moses says this to God. He said, God, show me your ways that I may know you. Moses was already up. He's already doing well. Had already brought the children of Israel out of Egypt. He says, Lord, show me your ways that I can know you and continue to find grace in your sight. I want your grace in my life. God, to continue. So that doesn't mean I got to be going through bad things. It just means, God, I just want you to keep it going in my life. I don't want to fail, God. I don't want to let you down. I don't want to quit. I don't want to give up. But there's some people in here today. You say, listen, man of God, pastor, I just want to continue. Step out into the aisle and say, I want to receive prayer. God, the God of the Bible, the God Jesus that's the same yesterday, today, and forever, will give me strength to continue. Hallelujah. Come on. Somebody here today, the Holy Spirit just laid it upon our hearts. Hallelujah. Laid it upon our hearts. Pray for those. Somebody here, you felt like you've been drifting away. Since things have been this hard, things have been this challenging, I've been drifting away. And God, I want to get myself back in line to continue. Yes, continue. I want to continue. I see the Holy Spirit working on you. The Holy Spirit's touching people's hearts. Come on, let's pray as they're coming. Let's pray as they're coming. I want to continue. I don't want to just be honoring my pastor, my bishop, my pastor, man of God, with words and great songs. But I want to continue. I want to just honor. I don't want to just speak well of Jesus in my words. I want to continue how I live, how I praise, how I pray, how I love my enemy, how I love my neighbor. Hallelujah. Lift those hands right there where you are. Hallelujah. Their whole family is up here because they say, I want my family to continue. I want the grace of God on my life to keep going. I want the grace of God on this house to keep going. I want the grace of God on my house to keep going. So Father, right now in the name of Jesus, God, I pray that your grace would continue.
Hallelujah. I pray, God, that your grace would continue. I pray that your anointing and favor would continue. I pray that your love would continue. Hey, I'm laying aside every weight and the sin that so easily throws me off course. The thing that's been tripping me up, God, I'm laying it aside right now. Hey, so I can continue. So I can press forward. So I can keep going. Thank you. I'm letting it go. I'm forgetting those things which are behind and pressing towards things that are before. Come on, lift those hands high and say, God, I want to continue. God, I want to continue. God, I want to continue. God, I don't want to keep. I don't want to quit. I don't want to stop. I don't want to give up. I'm not going in the towel. I'm making up in my mind and this place today that I'm staying with Jesus and I'm going all the way. I'm gonna continue. I'm gonna keep going. There's healing right now. Heal in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, make you every bit whole. The Lord make you every bit whole. The Lord make you every bit whole. And heal you. And heal you. By his stripes you are healed. Oh, you're healed. Healing right now. God says he's going to give you strength to continue. You never thought you would be going through this. Oh, but he knows where you are. He knows who you are. And he loves you. And you're going to continue. Hey, help is on the way. You're going to make it. You're going to make it. Saints been saying you're not going to make it. You're going to make it. Come on, fight the good fight of faith. Hallelujah. You're going to make it. You're going to make it. You're going to make it. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him. If you need strength to make it, hey, strength to make it. Strength to make it. I'm going to finish my course. I'm going to finish my course. I'm going to finish my course. Everything God put in you. Everything God put in you. It's coming forth even now. God, I pray for a fresh revival. A fresh oil. A fresh oil from the Holy Ghost. Oh. Oh, yes he is. Yes he is. Yes he is. God, remove every doubt. God, remove every doubt. He said he'll never leave you nor forsake you. You're not alone. You're not alone. You're not alone. You're not alone. Hallelujah. He's your strength. He's your strength. Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. Hey, come back on my motion. You lean on him. It feels like you're doing it by yourself. But God says he's holding you up. He's holding you up. He's holding you up. Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 The Holy Spirit is here for you. If you just reach out to him. Reach out to him. You can access him. You can access him. You can access him. Hallelujah. To every young person. To every adult. Hallelujah. Every young man, every man, every woman, come on, reach out to God right where you are. Reach out to God right where you are. Hallelujah, 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 heal right now, God. He's a healer. He's working. He's working. He's working. I would be like blind Bartimaeus. Jesus, why you're passing out blessings? Don't pass me by. Oh, Jesus, son of David. Don't pass me by. Hallelujah. He's working. Even if you can't see it, he's working. Even if you can't feel it, he's working. He's working. He's working in your soul to give you strength.
He's working in your family to hold you up. He's working in your marriage that it won't fall apart. He's working. He's working in your health that it won't fail. He's working. He's working. That you'll stay faithful in prayer. Hallelujah. He's working. Hallelujah. He's working. Oh, come on, worship him. Hallelujah. He's working. Come on, praise the one that's working in your life. Worship him. He's working in your life. He's breaking yokes in my life. He's breaking yokes in my life. He's breaking yokes in my life. Today, he's breaking yokes in your life. He's breaking yokes in your life. He's breaking yokes in your life.
Not tomorrow,
but today, 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 today. Yokes that have kept you tied down. Yokes that have kept you from progressing. Yokes that have kept you from moving forward. Attitudes that kept you bound. Unforgiveness that you haven't let go of. He's breaking yokes. Things that you've seen in the past. Things that hurt you and broke you in the past. He's breaking yokes in your life. He's giving you power to continue. Power to keep going. Grace to move forward. Hallelujah. While you're out there in the audience, you ought to say, God, destroy yokes in my life, in my family, in my child. Hallelujah, that we continue, that we keep going, that we finish the course. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He's breaking yokes in my life. He's leaving no stone unturned. Search me, God, and know my thoughts. Try me, God, and see if there be any wicked way in me. Lead me in the way everlasting. God, I pray right now, hey, oh, that you would heal, hey, oh, that you would heal. Lord, just say, lay hands on the sick and they would recover. And Father, I pray that in my system, the recovery process would begin. Not just the physical recovery, but the emotional recovery. Oh, the spiritual recovery. The Lord says you shall recover all. And you're going to have joy again, hey. You're going to have joy again. Where you've been battling with depression. He says he's going to give you the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. And you shall know that the Lord has done it. And when you can walk around and give him praise and not hurt. When you can remember and not break down. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, give joy. God, give joy. God gives joy and peace that passes all understanding. Let it may guard our hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Peace that passes all understanding. We shall guard our hearts and minds.
People still getting what they need from God. I wish I had some people that wouldn't rush. People are getting what they need from God. People getting strength to continue. The devil thought he was going to take them out.
Make them stop and make them quit. God is giving strength in this place to continue. Hallelujah. Keep going. To fight one more day. Go one more round. Hallelujah. My heart is fixed. My mind is made up to do all that God says do.
Come on, clap your hands for Jesus. Hallelujah. Saints that are going to continue. Come on, clap them like you're going to continue. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. We have decided to continue. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank God for the push. Thank God for the press. Thank God for the encouragement. We praise God for you being here today. Thank God for all your visitors. Thank God, amen. We're not going to prolong the service any longer. We want you to take that home. Take it with you. over the highways and byways. I will continue. Hallelujah. Thank God for you. Praise God for you, brother Carol. Thank God for you. Amen. Thank God for all of you. Go ahead and change that. Hallelujah. Are there any other announcements? Tony? Okay.
How you doing? Two final announcements. We have keys that was found in the ladies' restroom. So women, please check your purses. Because you can't continue home. without your keys. And last but not least, we still have shirts outside also as well for sale. So please don't forget, if you haven't gotten your shirt, make sure you get it on the outside. That's all I have.
Amen. Praise God. Ladies.
Good afternoon. This is not on the program, but the announcement earlier about the seminar that's coming up this weekend, April the 20th at 1 o'clock. It's kind of like a health wealth seminar, and it's not going to cost you anything. This is just information to inform you about insurances, wills, estates. There's going to be a legal aid representative here also to help you with some legal matters. And it's at no cost for the legal aid, but if you want to buy insurance from these agents, that'll be pretty much up to you. And it's very imperative that when you get elderly, you be prepared with your insurance, wills, and estates.